it's got to be good. You can't name your business Damn Mama Be Cooking and not be cooking. Welcome back, YouTube. It is Thursday, check-in day. Check-in went really well. We had 3 high days in a row. Actually ended up losing some weight after 3 straight high days. So just gonna stick to kind of maintenance calories right now. Today we're just hitting some shoulders and arms, and then we'll get legs tomorrow. So feeling pretty fresh, feeling pretty good. Shoulders, arms recover really quickly. Rarely get too sore, so I'm just going to push them a little bit harder today, starting off with just some triceps, warm up the elbows, and then we'll just kind of just go arms, and then or we'll just go triceps, biceps, and then just finish with a lot of volume in the shoulders. So we'll get medial and rear delts, and just really just try to get a lot of blood flow, a lot of high reps. Yeah, so just hitting some overhead triceps now. Really just good, well-rounded. Obviously going downwards, just regular tricep extensions. Now going overhead extension, just kind of biasing that lengthened stretch portion a little bit more long head of the tricep, just with those shoulders rotated back. After this, we'll hit some tricep kind of bias dips, and then we'll move on to biceps. One of the only opportunities we really have to start off with the triceps, even though they're kind of a glaring strength weakness, they're not really a hypertrophy weakness. So really needing to focus a lot more growth and tension on the chest and shoulders. and we'll work on building the arms up a lot more in the off season. We're actually in a caloric surplus. So right now the triceps looking pretty good, shoulders looking pretty good, chest could probably be a little bit better, but that's kind of always the case, especially in classic bodybuilding. So trying to stay a little bit more upright, and probably you'll notice I'm not really like leaning forward as far. I'm gonna get a little bit of front delt, a little bit of chest here, but I wanna try and keep it in the triceps a little bit, and that might mean I'm just also not going as low. So I'm trying to just keep tension in the triceps. As soon as I feel like it's shifting into the chest or the front delt too much, I just reverse the movement and work on that elbow extension. Kicking off biceps with some just standing incline cable curls. So just starting off that deep stretch position and just trying to get a lot of tension. It's got to be good. You can't name your business Damn Mama Be Cooking and not be cooking. Yeah, so we're just keeping the weight where it's at. As long as we get 10 reps. We don't get 10 reps, we drop the weight down. We're just trying to get 5 sets here. So in a perfect world, we'd get 5 sets, at least 10 with the same weight, but we're really pushing the weight, so it shouldn't end up that way. Gotta get after it tomorrow. Yeah, legs. A great shirt to be hitting an arm session in. Get those Super Saiyan arms. Okay, move on to a different arm movement now. Oh. Yeah, so just hitting this cable variation here so we can target that brachialis a little bit, go just kind of hammer curl grip, and just again hit the full spectrum of the bicep. Biceps definitely needing a lot more growth in the off season, a lot more attention. So really trying to just kind of maintain those as much as we can right now. Before we move on to shoulders, just finishing with some just high volume dumbbell alternating raises. So alternating curls, excuse me. But yeah, hit two sets at a kind of moderate weight. Now we'll hit two sets with some lighter weight, try to get about 20 reps in or so. Shoulder time. shoulder work. Sorry for the sun in my face. But shoulder work, really just gonna see a lot of lateral raises and rear delts, because we're gonna get obviously a lot of front delt, anterior delt activation whenever we do all of our pressing movements. So you won't see any kind of like compound pressing or anything today. We'll save that for Sunday. But yeah, so a lot of lateral raises, finish with some rear delt activation, and then be done with that. Just smart cam here. So we're gonna overload the bottom position, make it a little easier to get to the top, but hard to get out of the bottom. So putting more tension where that shoulder should be the strongest. Okay, we'll get a cable variation now. One big error I see people using the cables for lateral raises often is they set the arm way too low. And so at the bottom, you kind of run into the same position you do with the dumbbells. All that tension's kind of just pulling you down. So it's initiating a lot more tension through that trap. So starting off a little bit higher, we can keep that tension in the delt, and it's almost just like a sword drawing motion. We're kind of just coming out and slightly up. So it's a little bit of rear delt, but you're still getting a lot of medial delt and tension the entire time. Another really helpful cue is think about what your elbow is doing, not what your wrist is doing. I know we're loading with the ankle cuff on the wrist, but we want to think about trying to drive our elbow up, not our wrist. I feel like most people tend to feel a lot more rear delt when they focus on what their wrist is doing, because that's where all that force is being impacted. But if you focus on just driving your elbow up, similar to the machine we just did, it'll tend to isolate that rear delt or the medial delt a lot more. Okay, rear delt time. Kind of a high pull, face pull combination here. So working a little bit of external rotation for the shoulders, but it's all just kind of coming through those rear delts and kind of Terry's major. And for Spinetta, it's just a little bit, keeping it out of the trap. With rear delt flies, one cue that personally I find pretty helpful is I like to think about my pinky being slightly higher than my thumb. So I'm kind of like internally rotating that shoulder a little bit so I can drive out through that rear delt. So it's kind of a slight rotation of the arm and just scrape all that out with the rear delt. Get one more set here and then we will be done. Okay, so that is a wrap for today. We'll get a quick little pump check in my office slash messy kitchenette here at the gym. But yeah, just a little shoulder arm pump. So feeling good, feeling the lats are making progress in terms of opening up, and we're just gonna kinda go through. Had early morning cardio today, check in with Coach Nick today, and then we hit some posing practice, and then a little later in the evening after plenty of fuel, got some calories in, and got a good little shoulder arm pump. So started off with arms, really hit the triceps pretty hard, a lot of volume, then really just volume overall, a lot of arms. And then shoulders, kept it pretty simple, just some lateral raises, things like that, no shoulder presses, because we will shoulder press just a couple days from now. So not much else to update on. We are gonna get some post-workout and then we'll have one more meal after that today. And then we will be very fueled up and ready to go for a sick leg session tomorrow. So it'll be an early one because we gotta go through the process of moving, packing, and separating from our significant other. So fun little tidbit about life. But yeah, everything's moving in the right direction. Can't complain. So feeling really good about everything. Feeling really good about where we're at with a little more than 5 weeks left. And yeah, that is a wrap. Go ahead, like, subscribe, follow, do all the YouTube stuff. Love, hate, comment below. And yeah, that is a wrap. Bo Alexander, Adapt Fitness, Battle of Texas, a little more than 5 weeks out. And yeah, bye.